My name is Noelle Breckenridge. I'm 29 years old. I began stretching my ears when I was 15 years old. I was definitely drawn to stretching my ears. Not a whole lot of people were doing it, so it was definitely a unique thing that set people apart. When I first started, my ears were already pierced, so I started with jewelry that was just a little bit bigger. As I needed larger sizes, I got more creative and I would use things around the house, like drinking straws, pen caps, marker caps. At their largest, I stretched my ears to over an inch. My ears are stretched enough that I can get my fingers through them. I enjoyed it when I was younger, but I've definitely outgrown the stretched ears. The hair industry can be awesome because it really does allow more self-expression. But I also found that it was kind of a double-edged sword because I definitely felt some hesitation from people as I first met them to do their hair. I do wear my hair down most of the time to avoid showing my ears. I'd like to be able to wear my hair up. I feel like it should be in the past.
These are cute.
Thank you.
I've known Noelle for many years now, and she's my go-to hairstylist. She's the only one I trust.
When did you get gauges?
Well, when I was awesome and 16.
Of course.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I totally understand her wanting to get them fixed, just because as time goes, you know, gravity happens and things are just not as pretty.
It looks great. I love it.
Yeah.
If Dr. Lee was able to fix my ears, it would give me back like the ability to wear my hair the way I want. It's almost like a way of showing I'm a different person and this is a new me.
There's a patient named Noelle coming in today, and I hear she has some issues with her earlobes.
I'm really excited. I am a little bit nervous just because I don't know what the process is really gonna be like.
Hello.
Hi.
I have an appointment with Dr. Lee.
Perfect. Can I have you sign in for me?
I'm hoping that Dr. Lee can give me back my earlobes in a way that I can wear normal earrings again and to not feel like I have this old part of me that I've been dragging around.
Are you Noelle?
Yes.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
What are you here for? You look too cute. I don't even see anything going on with you.
I want my earlobes repaired because I had them stretched for a long time and this is as far as they've shrunk.
I love the color of your hair.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, yours were stretched a significant amount. What I look at is see how much earlobe you have left that is salvageable. You know, sometimes it thins it out a little bit.
I know people know me as Dr. Pimple Popper. They really expect me or travel from really far for me to pop their pimples, but I'm pretty darn good at repairing earlobes too. I really like that I can be a part of changing people's lives for the better when they've maybe made a decision in the past that they now regret.
So what you have to do in order to really repair an earlobe that's been stretched is the only way you can get the skin to get back together is to refresh the wound edges.
Yeah.
Cause then it like sort of, it becomes like glue, then you can stick it together. Mm-hmm. But of course you also wanna do that and still make it look like an earlobe, you know, that shape. So that's what we're gonna try to do. We're gonna try to probably try to hide the scar line right along the edge of our ear here. So hold this for me. So what I'm trying to do is, it's probably gonna be something like that.
Okay.
I am nervous about what's really possible. Hopefully, my earlobes will look normal again.
All right, let's do that, okay?
Sweet.
It's a tricky procedure to correct stretched earlobes like Noelle's because it's not just a straight side-to-side closure. This is a 3D sort of thing. It's not just a flat surface. You have an earlobe that has a lot of contours and turns to it. I like doing earlobe repair in particular because it's kind of like you have to fits puzzle pieces together, like it's Jenga or Tetris or something, and it really uses your creativity as a surgeon. Part of the earlobe has been stretched away, it's been thinned out, and you still want to, after the repair, make sure it still looks like a legitimate earlobe.
Oh, that's crazy.
I purposely hide the stitch right here, because if you put a stitch here, it oftentimes will get a little bump. I'm really, really happy with them. They look legit.
Yay! Thank you so much.
No, of course. That was fun.
Yeah.
It was really nice to meet you, too. You're lovely.
To see my earlobes new again, I think that it's inspiring. Now I can wear my hair up, so it's nice to be able to leave with a happy ending for my ears and for me.
No one will know that you have them. Only you.
Yay! I'm really excited that I have normal earlobes again.
Taylor is here. She has a big bump on the top of her tush, and it is attached to her spinal column.
Yo.
Hey, Dad, it's Bug. So I just talked to Dr. Lee, and she showed me the results from the MRI.
So there's no way that I can physically remove this entire lipoma, but I can potentially try to make it look better superficially. But she needs to know there's definite risk involved, so she has a big decision to make.
I love you, and you know, Mom and I are here for you.
I didn't want to make the decision without talking to you.
You know we're behind you 100%.
All right.
I love you, kiddo.
The decision I have to make right now is a big one, you know? She gave me my risk, my options, but you never know what could happen. I'm frightened. I'm very scared.
Hello, I'm back.
Hi.
Did you get a chance to talk to your family and...
I got to speak with my dad, and he seemed like it was, you know, it heavy, wasn't what we were expecting.
Heavy stuff, yeah.
Yeah, definitely way heavier than what we were told the first time, so. I think I'd like to proceed with making it just look a little better.
Let's see what we can do.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so let's get started, okay?
Okay.
Quick.
Even tugging on this lipoma in any way could potentially disrupt the growth within the spinal cord, and I don't want to do that in any way. All right, so I'm gonna put some numbing there.
The numbing's the worst part.
What? No, it's not gonna be bad. But I do think that I could remove a little of the superficial fat and the superficial skin to really make her crack in her tush look straight, and that is really all that Taylor's looking for.
There's a little line there. You see?
Oh my god.
Yeah?
Is that my first scar, that light pink? Or
No, that's your crack.
I've never got to see it before.
That's your crack right there.
Oh my god, I really have
it's
one.
It's a cute crack.
Holy crack. Really? Oh my god.
Yeah.
On a scale of 1 to 10, I'd say I'm 20 or higher right now. I am just so happy, so relieved. She made it look like I have a completely normal butt. And then what's so funny is I've wanted that my whole life. And now today I get to walk away from this blessed, happy to be alive from everything, and ecstatic that I can't even put it into words how happy I am.
No.
Here, see the little glove? That's probably what you're feeling underneath there.
I can't believe you just took that off.
Yeah.
Like nonchalant, like this is me right here.
That's right.
See you later, Lizzie. You're gone. You're out the door. I'm ready to be Taylor, not Taylor and Lizzie.
Thank you very much, Dr.
You're
Lee.
So welcome.
Means
you're
a lot
so
to me.
It's been 5 weeks since Noelle's earlobe repair, and her earlobes look fantastic. She can wear her hair up now, and she can finally be the person that she is now, and not that person that she was back when she was a teenager.